Students, myself Sumangla Virathar. In previous video, we already discussed about one of the relational algebra operations from set theory, that is the union operation. Now, in this video, let's see about remaining operations. Those are intersection operation, set difference or minus operation, Cartesian or cross product operation. First, we'll see what actually intersection operation. So, intersection operation, it is denoted by R intersect S A. Is a relation which includes all tuples that are present in both R and S, okay, and the operands must be type compatible. Type compatible means what? Number of the attributes in both the relation must be same and data type of the attributes must be same. So let's take one example, student and the instructor. So now if I take student intersection instructor, then result is what? You have to select only those tuples which are present in both the relation here. Let's check. So this is the one attribute which is present in both the relation. So yes, in the intersection at the end, if I intersect student as a R here and instructor as a S here. So now this is the present in both the tuples, that the result will got as a this one. Next I'll check the one more, this Ramesha. Yes, this attribute is also, sorry, this tuple is also present in this instructor also. Yes, you have to select here. Remaining you check. So Johnny, yes, no. And this one, Amy, Jimmy, MS, no, those attributes are not, sorry, those tuples are not present in the instructor table, okay. This is about your intersection. Intersection means what? It selects only those tuples which are present in both R and S here, okay. So, this is about your intersection. Is it clear now? Okay. Next, we'll go for the set difference of minus operation. So, it is denoted like this, okay. R minus S here. It is a relation which includes all tuples that are in R but not in S. The two operands must be type compatible. Okay, if I take the same example, student and the instructor. So if I take this one as a R relation and this one as a S, and if I take R minus S means what? It selects only those tuples which are present in student and those tuples are not present in instructor. Let's take student is R now and instructor is S. So it selects only those tuples which are present in student relation. So let's check, this is present here and here. So that's why I'm not selecting this tuple. Ramesh is also present in both the relation. That's why I'm not selecting this one. So next I'll go to the Johnny. S, it is present here only. Then you have to select this tuple. Next one is the Johns. Johns is also not available in instructor. This tuple you have to select. Next is Amy is also not there. Simi is also not there. MST is also not there. So these are the five tuples which are present in R but is not present in S here. So then that is the your result of the student minus instructor. This one. Set difference or minus operation means what? It selects only those tuples which are present in R here. If I take like this. Instructor minus student. What happens now? R is your instructor and S is your student. It is reversed. Now this is your R and this is your S. Then it selects which tuples now? Those tuples which are present in instructor. Okay. So now for example, if I take the John, it is not present in the this tuple S. Okay. Next in Brownie, it is also not present here. If I take the Sushan, it is present here. See here, it is present here. That's why I don't select that. So next is Francis, okay, Johnson, yes, Johnson is also not present here. I go for the Shah, Shah is present here and also it is present here. So only those tuples which are present in instructor, those tuples it selects 1, 2, 3, see Smith, Brownie and Johnson are the result here, okay. It is about your set difference or the minus operation. Is it clear now? Intersection means what? It selects only those tuples which are present in both the relation. Set difference or minus operation means what? It selects only those tuples which are present in the R relation. Next is Cartesian or cross product operation. This operation it is used to combine the tuples from both the relation in a combinatorial fashion. Combinatorial fashion means what? For example, result of R as a one relation, A1, A2, An are the attributes of the R and S, B1, B2, Bm are the attributes of the S here. So Cartesian product if you are using, then you are using this multiplication is a relation Q with a degree of what it is n plus m. It adds all the attributes of the R and also it takes the concatenation of the attributes of both R and S here. So if I take, then I'll get the all the attributes in the result as a Q. It contains attributes of R and also it contains the attributes of S here. So the resulting relation Q has one tuple from each combination of tuples, one from R and one from S here. So that is n, n of R, it is what it is, number of tuples of R. So that is denotes as a, this indicates what it is, number of tuples present in R, and S is the number of tuples present in S, and that Cartesian product you are taking like this, no, that one indicates what it is, number of tuples which are present in N multiplied with the number of tuples which are present in S here, So now these two operands do not have the type compatibility. Type compatibility means what? It is not compulsory that number of attributes must be same and data type of the attribute must be same. Whereas in the previous operation, in set theory operation like union, intersection and set difference or minus, type compatibility is very important, but here it is also, that is also not necessary. This is one example here. Now I want to retrieve all the employees, who work for the all the female employees, So name and first name, LM and SSN of the female employees I want to retrieve now. So for that here, so first when I execute this one, so as I told earlier, if any condition is there, that condition you can specify using one of the operation, which operation, that is the select operation as a sigma operator, condition and employee. So this is the result of that, female EMPs, that new result, all the tuples, who are female. So those tuples it selects from the employee table and it stores the those tuples in a new relation as a female EMPs. This is the resultant here. So these are the three employees are females here. Next is, so from this female employees, you are selecting only three attributes here. So project operation you are using to select the what? To select the attributes. So pi is an operator used to select the attributes. So how many attributes are there in female EMPs? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So among this, I want to select only the F name, L name and SSN. Okay, like that if you want to select, then you have to use this pi operator here. Okay, so if I select, then I got the new relation as a EMP F name. This is the result of this particular thing, second relation. Now if I use the, this is the female employees and EP names, and from this attributes are selected, this is the new resultant here. And this resultant, if I combine with the dependent, this, cross mark it indicates what it is. It is a Cartesian product, operation or a cross product here. How it works? Let's see. As I told, one tuple of the, this one, which one is your first tuple? So EMP name, this is your first tuple, and this tuple it combines with the all the tuples of the dependent here. See here how many times it is repeated? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 times. How many tuples are there independent? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. See? So first all the attributes of the this EMP name. So what are those? F name, L name, S name. Those values it repeats. Next it combines with the all the attributes of the dependent. Dependent table attributes are ESSN, dependent name, birth date and relationship. Okay, this is the thing you are combined here. These are the attributes of the dependents table and these are the attributes of the this EMP names here. So if you are use the cross product, how it works? One tuple of this EMP names, it multiplied with the all the tuples of the dependent table. That is 1 cross N here. Okay, so Ali, so Alisa, this is the first, that is 7 times you are repeated. Next is Jennifer, Jennifer is also 7 times if it is repeated, and Joyce, Joyce is also 7 times it is repeated. That is what we call as a Cartesian or the cross product here. One tuple multiplied or combined with the all the tuples of the other relation here, which relation you have taken. Is it clear now? So actual dependent, whatever the information you want to get now. So now here only one employee is the dependent, that is what here. So now here, female employee. So for among three employees, only one female employee is having the dependent, which is that employee, that is the Jennifer. Jennifer is having the dependent as what it is, Abna. So now this is the actual result here. Only one tuple is the actual result here. So if I display those information, result what it contains, F name, L name, the dependent name. This is your final result here. But if I use the cross product or Cartesian product, how many tuples I got here? 7 into, okay, 3 means what? 21 tuples you are got here. Among the 21, only one tuple is your actual tuple here. Okay. So remaining all are what? All remaining all tuples you call as spurious tuples here. Spurious means what? Unwanted tuples here. Among 21, 20 are unwanted tuples and 1 is the actual tuple here. So this is about your Cartesian or the cross product operation. Is it clear now? Okay. Thank you.